Hello, beautiful souls. Welcome back to my channel. This is Meg from megford.com, an adventure, travel, and minimalist blog. If you are interested, go ahead and subscribe to this channel. And then of course, check out my blog and all my social media handles down below in the description. So, okay, this video is all about the top five things to do as a family in Orlando. Obviously, Florida is a huge tourist destination. Families come from all over here to visit. There's a ton to do on the coast, some beautiful beaches, but I'm gonna be talking about the center of the state, Orlando, and the most fun things to do. So there's gonna be five things, and let's start with number five and then count our way down to number one. Number five is the Central Florida Zoo. So this is one of my personal favorites. I actually have like a membership to this place and take my kids all the time. It's really cute. There's a ton of fun things to do. The gift shop is adorable. The people that work there are really, really nice. And if you ask them questions about the animals, you will be surprised with how much they know. You can also feed the giraffes, which is something really cool. You can actually get really up close and personal with some of the animals, which makes this zoo a little bit different than other places. Okay, so number four is not gonna be an obvious one. I think number four should be downtown Sanford. Now, Sanford is just outside of Orlando. It's a little town east and north of Orlando. You just hop on I-4, it drops you right in. But downtown Sanford is very historic. It was actually the southernmost port because the St. John Rivers that went from the Atlantic Ocean all the way down to this Lake Monroe. So this town is absolutely gorgeous. The neighborhoods in this area are so well preserved. There's these like cookie cutter, adorable little like movie commercial type houses. They're all like 100 years old, all different colors, definitely picturesque. You're definitely gonna wanna drive around the downtown historic area. And then when you get to downtown, there's a ton of breweries and restaurants to check out. There's also, of course, the lakefront. There is a walkway that is paved that goes all, it's going to go all around the entire lake. Right now, it's just like the southernmost part of the lake, and it's really nice and really well kept. It seems like every weekend they have something new going on. Every time I look it up, there's like this new festival of like a beer festival with dogs that they call Pints and Paws. And then there's like, like a German festival, and then there's like an international food festival. Like there's something happening every single weekend in this place with food vendors and craft vendors and a bunch of stuff. So if you do want to go check out some of the festivals, if you just want to go and visit the like 10 million breweries that are down there, go ahead and do that. What's great about some of these breweries and restaurants and spots is that they're very family friendly. They have places for the kids to run around. My personal favorite is Celery City because it's so big, but it's also fenced in. It's a great place for the kids to just run around while you just sit and relax. Okay, number three on the list of five places that you should go as a family in Orlando is Icon Park. So Icon Park is sort of like a park slash outdoor mall. It has hundreds of restaurants and shops. It also has a couple of attractions. There is an aquarium that you can go to. There's a big iconic Orlando Eye, like they call it, kind of like the London Eye, but it's an encapsulated Ferris wheel and you can just see for miles, because Florida's super flat. And on a good day, the visibility is miles and miles. So in Icon Park, there's not just like 40 million different shops and restaurants to go to. There's also an express train. There's a 7D ride adventure. There's the Orlando Star Flyer. There's a Madame Tussauds. There's an Arcade City. I mean, there's so much to do in this place. And I think the best part is that it is completely free parking. It's completely free parking and entry. You do have to pay for each individual like attraction, but you could just go experience it, you know, go to the shops, go to the restaurants, and then definitely don't pass up the encapsulated Ferris wheel. If you're gonna do one thing, you gotta do the Icon Park Ferris wheel. You got to. Okay, so number two in places to visit as a family in Orlando is Universal Studios. Universal Studios is kind of like a two-park situation. So it's Universal Studios and Islands of Adventure, and it's your typical theme park. It has a bunch of rides, it has characters. It's really a great place to go in the winter time, because that's when I visited this past year. Florida gets really, really hot, and I know everybody wants to come on your summer break, but just be prepared for the temperatures, it will be over 90 degrees and sometimes over 100 degrees and humidity. So just keep that in mind. Universal is really fun. It's really great. There's rides for every ages. I do want to preface it with, like, I feel like Universal is for a little bit older. So if you have kids under 5, there are a couple things for them to do. There's a Dr. Seuss area and there are some rides, but the majority of those parks are for the older kids. And if you're a Harry Potter fan, like, you just have to go. You have to go to both parks because there's a Harry Potter area in both Islands of Adventure and Universal Studios. So go to both parks. All right, so the long anticipated number one thing to do as a family in Orlando is, of course, my favorite place on the planet, the most magical place on earth, Walt Disney World. Walt Disney World Resort property is ginormous. It is not just a little Disneyland and California Adventure like they have over in Anaheim in California. This is an entire city of itself. Walt Disney World has tons of resorts with its own restaurants, attractions, and amazing things to check out. There are 4 major parks. We have, let me think about it. Magic Kingdom, which is the largest. That's the one with Cinderella's Castle that if you haven't been to Disney, you need to go to that one. Next we have Epcot with the big ball. A lot of countries represented, a lot of amazing food and drinks and festivals all year round. Don't skip Epcot. And then we also have Hollywood Studios, which has Toy Story Land, Galaxy's Edge, a whole Star Wars land area. That park is absolutely incredible. It also celebrates old Hollywood, and I love that kind of thing. And then we also have Animal Kingdom, which is kind of like Africa, Asia, dinosaurs, a zoo, a safari. It's so much in one. I really think it's the most picturesque park. Epcot is my favorite, and then next is Animal Kingdom, and then next is, of course, Magic Kingdom, and then Hollywood Studios. So in my opinion, that is the order of greatness. Disney World also has an incredible outdoor mall that is completely free to go in to park at, and it's called Disney Springs, and it's a place that has concerts. There's also a Cirque du Soleil that's coming out really soon. Hundreds of shops and restaurants to choose from. I suggest that you go and just go window shopping, see what, you know, tickles your fancy, and then do an appetizer tour. You gotta hit more than one place here because there's so much delicious food and amazingness, and of course, you know, free shows and cute little attractions and things to do. I actually have a vlog for each of these 5 places, or at least a blog post link, or at least an Instagram link with a little bit more information. I'll put all of that down in the description below. If you have a trip planned for Orlando or anywhere in Florida, because that's where I live, please let me know. Put it down in the comments and let me know also where you're watching from, because I'm super curious where people find me and they're watching this channel. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more content. And of course, let's be friends on social media. Click all my buttons down below in the description so we can be friends on social media. And I will see you next time. Bye.